COSACE today intensified its inquiry into the operation of the Uganda Printing and Publishing Company, UPPC. The committee discovered that a one staff in UPPC, Robert Chigonya, was paid 1.5 billion shillings as commission for securing for the company a deal from the Electoral Commission to gazette winners of 2021 general elections.
Mr. Chigonya, Robert.
How much?
It was the figure is like 1.5 billion. I'm not sure.
1.5 billion?
Yes.
To this individual?
Yes.
How?
The Electoral Commission offered UPPC a deal of 15.4 billion shillings for Gazette in 2021, but 1.5 billion shillings was paid to the marketing executive of UPPC, Chigonya. However, the deal went bad and all officials involved were arrested and charged before the Anti-Corruption Court. The committee faulted UPPC officials for subjecting the statutory business of Electoral Commission to commission terms, yet UPPC has the monopoly by law to gazette election winners.
So it's not like this person went to the Electoral Commission and said, no, please don't take your business to Monitor, to Vision, bring it to UPPC. It could only be you people. And by the way, the Electoral Commission is commanded by law to gazette with you people. So how does this then get to happen and commission is?
I think by law, you'll correct me.
That's
by,
exactly what
by
I just
law
said.
To UPPC, no, I'm saying UPPC, that the only people who can gazette.
That's
no,
exactly
no
what
any
I said.
Other. No any other.
So respond so to no that, option. Sir.
And
let's
order.
Allow him to respond because we are repeating order. Ourselves.
This happened before I took over as managing director. And I would want to categorically state that without delving deep into details of the case that is before the courts of law, that this could probably be one of the questions that is going to be asked.
The committee detained the UPPC company secretary, Connie Ariada, with Parliament Police after she declined to reveal details of the controversial deal on grounds that the matter is before court.
How was it spent?
We'll give you the general breakdown of the spending of the 15.4 billion, but then members should not delve further into the payment of the commission.
Madam.
Because you will even still ask for documents, we will not have any documents relating to that because they are all taken.
You know, we are going to arrest this woman here.
Yeah, she's ruling now.
Because you seem to want to rule in this committee. Mr. MD. We are going to arrest this staff of yours because she's operating in contempt of this committee.
Sorry, Honorable Chair.
What we want is accountability.
In the same meeting, the committee established that several government ministries, departments and agencies have not been paying for UPPC services and debts have accumulated to 4.3 billion shillings.
People who owe you up to 4.3 billion shillings, what have you done to try and recover this money? I see some huge amounts, Electoral Commission, 400 million, Ministry of Internal Affairs, 1.7 billion.
Civil Aviation Authority, we have 5.9. Clerk of Parliament,
5.8. 5.9 what?
Shillings.
5.9 shillings? Million, billion what? Or trillion?
Okay, 5,999,000.
That's which one?
That is Civil Aviation Authority.
Okay.
These include the Electoral Commission, Minister of Finance and Minister of Agriculture, among other defaulters. Committee members wondered how government agencies access services and default while other Ugandans have to pay before getting services of the Gazette.
There is no single Ugandan who goes for gazetting in this country without first paying to UPPC.
To make matters more complicated, UPPC is considering to write off some bad debts after documents pertaining to some sales went missing. MPs interrogated UPPC officials on the criteria and justification for writing off bad debts. UPPC explained that they have recruited one Cosmas Kanyike as a debt collector to help the entity to follow up on pending debts. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.